Welcome back to another quick tutorial. Today we are going to dive into how to manually turn disk rate caching on or off on your Windows 10 or Windows 11 computer. It's a handy tip to boost performance or protect your data, and it's a pretty straightforward process. So let's jump right into it. To get started, open up File Explorer. If you have the folder icon on your taskbar, just click it to launch. No icon, no problem. Just hit the search bar, type File Explorer, and open it from there. Once it's up, look over on the left panel and click This PC. That will show you all your drives. Now find the drive you want to adjust, maybe your C drive, an external hard drive, whatever, and right-click it. From the menu that pops up, select Properties. In the Properties window, switch over to the Hardware tab and click it. You will see a section labeled All Disk Drives. Scroll if you need to, then left-click the specific drive you want to tweak, highlight it, and hit the Properties button below. Another window will open. Here, click the Change Settings button. You might get a prompt asking for permission. Just hit Yes if it shows up. Now, in this new window, head to the Policies tab. This is where the important settings are. You will see an option that says Enable Write Caching on the device. If you want to turn it on for better performance, check that box. If you'd rather turn it off to avoid the risk of data loss during a power outage, uncheck it. There's a little note here, enabling write caching can speed things up, but a sudden power loss might corrupt your data, so weigh that risk. Below that, there's a sub option, turn off Windows write cache buffer flushing on the device. Only check this if your drive has its own backup power like a battery to safely flush the buffer during a blackout. Most don't, so leave it unchecked unless you're sure. Once you have made your choice on or off, just click OK to save it. Click OK again on the next window. And one more time to close out Properties. That's it. You have set your disk write caching exactly how you want it. For a simple recap, if this tweak worked for you, hit the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe for more helpful tips. Catch you all in the next tutorial. Stay tuned.